He got off the plane, took a deep breath, shed his skin, and jumped off.
Now, I assume this is a photograph.
Four color. That water is transparent.
Well, I suppose it reminds me a little of the cinema. But mostly, I see James Mason at the end of that movie walking into the sea.
What is that movie?
I'm not sure I know what you're talking about.
He's killing himself. I don't think they show it, but he's going to swim out until he can't swim back.
That may be a personal association for you, but that's not what this means.
We looked at this. None of us thought of that.
A Star is Born.
The copy is all about the Hawaiian legend. Aloha means hello and goodbye.
I'm sorry, but this is very poetic.
Thank you.
Where's our hotel? Where's the Pink Palace?
Well, there's no reason we can't tilt the camera up 45 degrees and see the husk of our city dweller on the sand and,
So there would be a man in this photo and he'd most likely be naked.
Actually, my first thought is there is no man, just his footprints. What happened to him?
I think people might think that he died.
Maybe he did, and he went to heaven.
Of course, there's no doubt this concept itself is merely a jumping off point.
A picture of a hotel, even yours, is easy to ignore. This, or some version of this, demands your attention.
Well, you will continue to have our attention.
Make no mistake, we're not afraid of provocative. She's biological and Jewish.
She's technically Jewish.
She's Jewish.
Jewish enough.
But we're not in St. Louis celebrating Sukkot with her.
Yeah, she doesn't celebrate Sukkot.
Most Jews don't. I don't have, like, the numbers or anything, but I'm willing to bet that most Jews don't. It's okay. My point is that even though he's no longer married to our mother, and even when he moved to Hawaii, we still haul ourselves here to celebrate with him.
You don't know, but, started yelling your name in some pretty fucked up neighborhoods. But I know I wouldn't stop looking for you. I remember when I finally found you at the bus stop. I was like, this woman doesn't mess around when she gets angry. You're the only one I know like that.
I can't believe what I just saw.
What? What did you see?
I think I saw a vampire.
After all these years, we meet again.
Why, yes, here we are. Only this time, I brought along a couple of friends.
You know, you can tell a lot about a person from their guest bedroom.
It is the one place where you put the least amount of effort. Therefore, you see what really matters. Is this her?
Yeah, with her husband, Dion.
Oh, she's faking it through this one.
What are you talking about?
Look at this room. She's thought of everything. She really wants company.
They were high school sweethearts.
Jeez, that's like saying grade zero heroes. They didn't know who they were then, and they sure as hell can't know now. I mean, they probably watch Lifetime for pointers on how to prescript a dinner conversation. Hoping that the other one doesn't realize that they ran out of things to say about 7 years ago.
I may have just met you, but seriously, there's something wrong with you.
Oh, I might be wrong. I mean, the field of gastrology is really still in its infancy.
Of course. You've never settled enough to be the host.
I never really thought about it. And in my line of work, perpetual guesthood hazarded the job.
Sounds lonely.
Sometimes. But last night, I met you.
Nobody leaves me! Nobody!
No!
Jennifer. I love
I love you.
Stan, tell me. Tell me.
I love you.
What?